Welcome to Eye Care Central. In this video, we will discuss the grading of corneal opacities and also how to differentiate between them on clinical examination. We will start with some basic revision of cornea and its layers. So, cornea is a transparent and avascular structure. It has five layers: the anterior epithelium, the Bowman's membrane, corneal stroma, Descemet's membrane, and the corneal endothelium. The corneal stroma is made up of collagen fibrils. The reason why cornea is transparent is because of the regular spacing and arrangement of these collagen fibrils. So if due to any reason this arrangement of collagen fibrils is disturbed, it leads to loss of corneal transparency. Corneal opacity refers to the loss of transparency of cornea due to the formation of a scar. So cornea can lose its transparency due to any cause that disturbs its structure, like corneal edema, corneal dystrophies, corneal degenerations, etc. But under this topic, we will specifically talk about the opacities that form due to healing or scarring. Corneal opacities have been classified into three grades on the basis of their density. First is nebular corneal opacity or nebula. Second is macular corneal opacity or macula. And third is leucomatous corneal opacity or leucoma. Nebular is the mildest form. Macular is denser than nebular, and leucomatous is the most dense form. Histologically speaking, nebular corneal opacities develop when there is damage to Bowman's membrane along with the superficial stroma. Superficial stroma means that less than 1/3 of the total stromal thickness is affected. In macular corneal opacities, more stroma is involved, that is why they are denser than nebular opacities. So in macular opacities, up to half of the thickness of stroma is affected. And finally, in leucomatous opacities, more than half of the stroma is involved. Now, this was all theoretical. It is important to know how to differentiate between these opacities on clinical examination. It is very easy to miss nebular corneal opacities on torchlight examination because they are very faint. So, to identify them clinically, slit lamp examination must be done on all patients because slit lamp gives us a magnified view of the cornea. So to grade an opacity as nebular, we try to visualize the iris that is behind the opacity. In nebular corneal opacities, the iris can be visualized clearly and we can also appreciate the details of the surface of the iris, like iris crypts, iris furrows, etc. very easily. Macular corneal opacities are denser, so if we try to see through them on slit lamp examination, we will be able to see the iris, but it will not be possible for us to appreciate the iris details easily. Leucomatous corneal opacities are very dense and they do not allow light to pass through them at all. So if you observe it on slit lamp, the iris behind them cannot be visualized. So our next topic is adherent leucoma. But before moving on to that, let us revise the features of these corneal opacities again. So nebula is the least dense of them all. Then comes macular opacity, which is moderately dense, and the densest of them all is leucomatous. In nebula, 1/3 of stromal thickness is involved, in macula, up to half of stromal thickness is involved, and in leucoma, more than half of the stromal thickness is involved. Lastly, on slit lamp examination, iris and its details can be seen clearly through a nebular opacity. In case of a macular opacity, the iris can be seen, but its details are hazy, and in leucomatous corneal opacities, the iris cannot be seen at all. So another term that is frequently encountered while discussing corneal opacities is adherent leucoma. So what is adherent leucoma and how does it form? The word adherent means that two things are stuck to each other, they are connected, they are joined together. So in adherent leucoma, the iris is adhered or it is stuck to the back surface of the cornea. So this is a clear transparent cornea. In cases of corneal ulcer, when the infiltration and inflammation has reached the deeper layers of cornea, which means that not only have they involved the entire thickness of the stroma, but they have also reached up to the Descemet's, leading to a corneal perforation. When corneal perforation occurs, it causes sudden leakage of the aqueous humor through this perforation. So the aqueous gushes out of the wound and along with it, the iris also gets dragged. A part of the iris plugs the area of perforation, and when healing and fibrosis occur at that site, with the iris still plugging the cornea, it forms an adherent leucoma. So we can say that adherent leucoma is a healed perforation with iris incarceration. In the next video, we will talk about the various causes of corneal opacities and their treatment. If you found this video useful, please like it and share it with your friends and colleagues. If you want to see more such videos, please subscribe to my channel to support it. Thank you very much.